I've had a really long day at work. I've been at it for maybe 17, 18 hours. You are really glad that YouTube is not an olfactory medium. Okay, now, making this video is going to be very hard because I'm by myself. It would be far easier if I was talking to someone. Okay, different video. Different video because I need a second person to talk to, otherwise I'm talking to myself. Over here I'm talking to you, but if you're not responding, I can't explain the point I'm trying to explain. So, different video. Okay. Cut. New video. Here's an actual practical advice for bald guys who are trying to date. Okay? This won't work for anyone else. Only bald guys can use this. Okay? It's got to do with pickup lines. Now, never use a pickup line. Pickup lines are dumb. Dumb. Okay? Dumb. How do you start regular conversations with other friends and other just people? Do you just start conversations with people by having some preset line that you deliver? Like, that would be ridiculous. I mean, okay, for example, pickup lines don't work, ever. Okay, so never use pickup lines. That's just fucking dumb. Alright, and if you believe pickup lines work, you are very inexperienced. Simple as that. Because you'll quickly learn that they don't work if you use them. So don't even, just skip that whole part. Never even try pickup lines. It's dumb. How you can start conversations with women, though, is the same way you start conversations with anyone. Alright? Say, for example, if I was going to be out shooting photos of stuff, whatever that might be, right? Say you're at the beach and there's a guy taking a landscape photo. I could say to him, oh well, what camera do you use? You know, what lens is it? How much does it cost? What's the aperture? What's the, you know, what f-stop are you on? Are you using any filters? Whatever, you know, and then he might say what he's using, and he'll ask you what sort of things you're doing, and you've got your camera, for example, and this is a macro lens for shooting really close-up stuff. So he might say, I'm just here to shoot like close-up things of maybe seashells or different grass or bugs or crabs or whatever you find at the beach, but little detailed, tiny little things. Now, that's almost like a pickup line, kind of, but it's like a question that you use to start a conversation. So rather than pickup lines, with the intention of trying to get the girl attracted to you, all you want to do is start the conversation. And an easy way to start a conversation is to ask a question. Okay? Now, the easiest way to ask a question is to ask something about the surroundings that are around you. You literally have to do nothing other than look around and say, oh, you've got a camera. What camera is that? You know, but a girl could have a camera. You might be taking photos and there's an attractive, oh my gosh, you're so hot, girl with a camera, and you could just do the thing I said before. You could ask her, all the settings. What are the settings on your camera? Let's see what you've done. Go back and look at some of the shots and all that. So you could easily start a conversation that way. And it's not awkward and creepy and shit, because you obviously have, for example, quite an expensive lens yourself. You're not just awkwardly trying to start an inorganic conversation with some shitty pickup line. You're actually having a regular conversation about cameras. Now, you're probably not going to find a girl photographer because it's such a dorky thing. It's great. I love taking photos. It's amazing. But I don't know. It's like a really nerdy thing, I think. I don't find many women do it. Actually, no, I do know some. Yes, I've got some friends. Okay, scratch that. Yes, girls do take photos. It's an easy thing physically. I mean, the camera's only a couple of kilos, and most lenses aren't too heavy either. So yeah, a girl can carry a camera around. Like, you're not gonna find many girl mechanics, because gearboxes are fucking heavy, but cameras are not so bad. So yeah, okay, that's one. But don't start photography just to start to meet women, because it's not like makeup. If you start learning about makeup, yeah, there's plenty of women there. But if you happen to like photography and that's what you're doing, then you can start a conversation that way. Let's find a different example. Vinyls. Ha! Well, this is a Serbian vinyl, but... Womack. Oh, this is good. This is a really good record. You could perhaps be out at a club and there could be a girl DJing. If you're a DJ, bang, you know, what sort of music do you spin? Is this normally what you play, or is it just like a, you know, something that you play just because they're paying you to play it? What equipment do you use? You know, where do you go? What kind of setup do you have at home? How many vinyls do you have, if that's what you use? Or maybe you just, you know, do you use MP3s, or, you know, you're on USB or CD? Do you do any, what's it called, do you like use effects, or are you more just the sort of DJ that plays just songs, or do you just fuck shit up with effects everywhere? Plenty of questions you can ask there, and you can actually start, because this person is DJing. Trust me, DJing is like better than sex. It's the best thing ever. You just get lost in it and it's exciting as fuck. Alright? When you do it, to you. To other people, you're just standing there and you're just pushing a few things. And like I said, you could be very active or very inactive, but either way, as a DJ, you are having so much fun. You don't even know what time it is or anything. But if you start a conversation, now, of course, she could be trying to get rid of you because she's trying to do her job, but maybe later on, someone else will replace her and she'll just be sitting there, and then you can, you know, ask her questions about that. And as I'm trying to say, but I keep cutting myself off for a change, she'll likely be very enthusiastic about the conversation. It doesn't always have to be something that you see her doing, though. It could be anything. Anything situational sort of around you in the surroundings. Perhaps you see a naked guy ride past on a bicycle, alright, and you're sitting at a bus stop and there's just a woman next to you, and this guy just rides past, and you look at each other and you just go, what the shit did we just see? Don't sit there and say nothing. If you see something ridiculous, tell someone. They've seen it too, and you guys just saw the same thing. You can, for example, it's like, does he know he's naked? Like, has he, you know? And then, I don't know where that would go, but, really, okay, let's find a good example. Like, I'll start conversations with everyone all the time. It's good practice. Like, I mean, it's good fun for me. I just talk to people, and sometimes I'll say ridiculous shit and people get, like, kind of weirded out that this total stranger is telling them whatever it is that I'm telling them. But other times you end up having a good laugh with someone. So always start conversations with everyone. So it will actually come in useful to you when you need it, when there's a hot girl. But if you just start a conversation with a guy at EB Games, whatever, video game store, and you end up having a good laugh with him for 5 minutes, well, you just had a fun conversation about God knows whatever, right? So you'll have fun in general when you are more social, but it's all practice. So you don't just go and start conversations with women, start conversations with everyone. Everyone. Oh, dude, That's an NBN box. Did you just get it installed? Yes. Oh, wow. You know, what's the speed that you've got? Oh, well, whatever. You know, upload speed's this. It's not that impressive, but it's a lot faster than what I used to have before I got NBN. But, you know, now I can upload YouTube videos like 5 times quicker than before. Yeah. That could be a logo on someone's jacket, and you could just ask them, oh, wow, the jacket, you know, do you work for that company? Yeah, yeah, it's great, you know, I get to travel around the world and do these things, blah, blah, blah. Whatever. You just see something, mention it to them, all right? Now, let's say, okay. Let's say you're in a bar. Trying to pick up women in places where people go to pick up women is just like setting yourself a handicap, because they go there and they're already watching out for you creeps that are trying to pick them up, right? So I think it's much better just at the shops or wherever you are. But in any case, women do go out looking for guys too. So that's part of the reason why they go to bars and clubs as well. It's just that the whole environment, I don't like it. I love nightclubs, but I just don't like picking up women at nightclubs, because you can't even talk to them. It's all noisy, and the only way you ever do that is just through grinding against each other, and, you know, grinding against strangers is just not that appealing to me, right? Never was. But I digress. Back on topic. Let's say you're sitting in a bar or a cafe or whatever, and you and your friend are talking, and there's a couple of girls sitting next to you, and someone walks past and they've got a tattoo of a moon on their neck, and you could just be like, hey, did you just see that, you know, whatever, that lady or whoever with the neck tattoo, the moon? And they're like, oh, wait, no, I didn't. And it's like, yeah, I don't know, she had this big moon on the side of her neck. Oh, which reminds me, I bought this, I do some photography, and I bought this big lens. The super moon was going to be out. It's like when the moon's a few percent closer to the Earth, and it's only ever so slightly imperceptibly bigger than it normally is to the naked eye. But yeah, I went out and I bought this huge lens, and I was sitting outside my house when the moon was supposed to be out, and this is the biggest it's probably going to be in my lifetime. So I was determined, and I sat there, and I was covered in mosquitoes. Covered. Because the clouds were out, and the moon wouldn't show itself. This is, by the way, a true story. The moon wouldn't show itself, so I was sitting there on one of those fishing chairs with the tripod, which this camera's on, and the big ass lens, and I'm just sitting there pointing the lens at the moon and just waiting. So for an hour, I was sitting in a cloud of mosquitoes, and you wouldn't believe it, I never got bitten. Not one. Not one. Now, at the time, I was driving, I still do, my job is to drive trucks. So I was doing a lot of driving. This was just before New Year's Eve, and that's crazy time. There's way too much work. So I was drinking a lot of coffee to just keep up with everything, to stay awake and have the energy to keep going. And energy drinks, actually, which is more important. Energy drinks. So I was drinking a lot of them. Apparently, here's an interesting fact. If you go outdoors, vitamin B repulses mosquitoes. For some reason, the mosquitoes are kind of ignore you if you consume a lot of vitamin B. That's what I heard, anyway. On I think on like Joe Rogan's podcast or anything, if you've heard of that. I highly recommend you listen to Joe Rogan's podcast. I don't always agree with what he's saying, but the good thing there is, you, even when you don't agree, you're challenged. You hear new ideas. And he's always got different guests, like doctors and actors and comedians and musicians and all sorts of sports people and, you know, scientists and god damn it, just everyone. He's just got all sorts of guests on his show, politicians, whatever, and and you just get to hear about things that you've never heard before. Now, he goes hunting a lot with guns and arrows and whatnot, and so, you know, he's been in situations where mosquitoes were quite a big issue. So that's where I heard that vitamin B is something that chases mosquitoes away. Now, here's the other thing. Videos are combined again. I just changed topics like 3 or 4 times. I went from tattoos. I mean, you could also say, oh, I digress. I was talking about the moon tattoos. Now, I think that was crazy. I would never get a tattoo like that because you can't get rid of something like that, especially if it's, when it's on your face or on your neck or something. You can always see it. One day, though, when they've got nanomachines, they can just eject and they spread all over your skin, and then you can use an app on your phone to, like, upload a picture to your skin. Yeah, I'll be down for that. Well, you can just delete it and change it at will, but not permanent ink. Fuck that. But, you know, are you crazy enough to have any tattoos? And then they'll be like, oh, yes, I got this when I was 16, blah, blah, blah. And then you talk about that. Where I was going before, yes, segues. Change your topic of conversation often. Don't stay stuck on one thing. If you start talking to someone about cameras, now, these things are beautiful. These things are beautiful. I could talk to you about lenses for days, but you won't want to talk to me about lenses for days. Now, people do like to see that you are enthusiastic about something, but if they don't share your passion, yeah, it's going to get old. So, do talk passionately about topics that interest you, definitely, most certainly. And be passionate about different things. I've told you that, I think, in one of the earlier videos. Be passionate. But do change topics. Because one of the most awkward things is when you see people that are obvious in the first date is they'll try and just keep going with the same topic forever. Right? Have you seen that? Like, it just drags on and it's painful. It's just painful. Like, you exhaust that topic, but you still try and cling to it. There's nothing there to be said anymore. So, change topics often. Start a conversation. Oh, this ties in so well. Start a conversation about something, ask them a question, and then change the topic after that. They might say something. It's like, well, that's a tattoo of my pet when I was, you know, like 7. I had this little dog and he was the best, and I always walked him, and then, you know, we moved and we had to give him to, you know, some relative or whatever, and I don't know. And then you could say, oh wow, you know, I've got a cat, Chi-Chi, she's my cat, and she goes with me in the truck, she goes to work with me. I'll occasionally, depending on what sort of work I'm doing, if I'm spending a lot of time inside the truck, inside the cabin, driving, then I will bring her with me. So, a few times a month. But she's great. She just lies down, sleeps for most of the time. I'll come in, you know, I'm in and out of the truck. I'll come in and she'll kind of come up to me and I'll cuddle her, and I have her food there and the kitty litter. And yeah, it's great. She keeps me company when I'm traveling. Because all truck drivers have dogs. Not all, but a lot of truck drivers bring their dog with them. And I like to be different. And I don't need to prove how manly I am, so I have a cute little cat with me. And, you know, just change the topic like that. Literally, just, she'll be talking about something, and all you have to say is, oh yeah, that reminds me of something. And then change the topic. Now, what she's saying doesn't even have to remind you of anything. But who's to say that it doesn't remind you? This thing. Record cleaner. It's for cleaning vinyls. AM. I don't know what that stands for. But it could be amplitude modulation. It could be perhaps I could start talking about making music, using software to make music. Now, it's something I'm playing around with. Amplitude modulation is when you have a sound at a certain volume, and then you have another wave which you can't hear, but you use the position of that wave, the amplitude of that wave, to bring the volume of the first one up and down. So as this wave goes up and down, it's really just controlling the volume of this one. So you'll be like, ah, 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 as that wave's being made. It would of course remind me of records, of vinyls. You can see an object and it will just remind you of 100 different things. You could, as you listen to the other person, okay? As they're talking, something at some point will remind you of something. So if you want to change the topic, easy as that. Oh, which reminds me, a couple of minutes ago, you mentioned whatever it is, witches' hats. You mentioned witches' hats on the, you know, the roadworks, like those big cones. And there's a restaurant in the city called Witches in Bleachers, I believe. I think it's like some kind of theater slash restaurant. I've been driving past that building for the last 20 years, and I've been telling myself I want to go. And the only time I ever remember is when I drive past it, and then when I actually have time to go, never, ever does it cross my mind. Yeah. Just topic change. Boom. Then you can talk about witches. Talk about the Salem trials, where they burnt all these, I think women predominantly. They were blaming each other. Everyone was accusing each other of being witches, and yeah. Whatever, man. Whatever. And again, the more interests you have, the more you know on various topics, the more you're going to have to talk about. Maybe you heard something in your news, maybe you heard something on the podcast, maybe you read something in a book, whatever. There's a million places where maybe someone told you something. Ask them a question, then talk to them about that for a couple of minutes, and then change the topic. Do anything. It doesn't matter. Because that's how, when people, like, see, me, I'm talking to you, I feel comfortable with you. You are a camera at the moment, but you represent 18,000 people, give or take. I know most of you don't watch most of my videos, but whatever. I mean, that's how many people are subscribed. So, I feel comfortable around you, and I talk freely about everything. Everything. Change topics often, because when you talk to your friends, you'll realize that that's what you do. That's what you do with your friends. And that's what you want the woman to feel like around you. You want her to feel like she's comfortable with you. Like you are friends, I suppose. Now, of course, you might want that to go further, but the important thing is that she feels comfortable, and not that you are artificially struggling to keep the conversation going, because then it just draws attention to what's happening and the whole thing just melts down. And if it does, that's fine. Like I said in another video, learn from your mistakes. What was it that you did? It was probably that you didn't change the topic. Go back and think about, you know, what she said. Oh yeah, that did remind me of that time when I was a child and I had that little tricycle, and my grandpa ran over it with a tractor. Whatever, you know, that's something that happened. But never mind. And don't make things up. Surely you've got a million things that have happened to you that you can be reminded of during the day. And literally, if you just go up to someone and ask them a question and they say, yes, yeah, that's it. You can just be like, oh, okay, cool. Thanks. If things don't go your way, just politely end it. That's it. You know, hey, what did you just see the naked guy on the bicycle? Yep, pretty creepy. And then she just keeps reading her book. Well, that's fine. cool. Alright, whatever. Just kind of laugh. Huh, yep, crazy guy. And just go back to your Facebook on your phone. Not the end of the world. Not even the beginning of the end of the world. It's not even a bad thing. And at the end of every interaction, think back what you did right, what you did wrong, and then over time, after a long time, you'll just get better and better at having regular conversations with people. So that's the end of this rambling, tired guy video. Good night. Yeah, you're not gonna get sleep. Enjoy the rest of your day. And when you're out and you have a chance to say something to someone, just say it. To anyone, anything. Say it.